This is a magnetic coil ring retainer for some sort of a motorcycle. I don't really know the details. Client sends me the CAD, I 3D print the part, and now I'm going to make an open face silicone mold so that they can then make more of these parts for their project.
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making.
Alfred backpack hanger in stainless steel and aluminum, designed by me, holds your backpack, lets you charge your phone, holds your keys, super versatile. So I'm packing up some here that were recently sold. Thanks for those of you who've purchased recently. It really helps support the channel.
This is the failed part inside of some sort of housing from the motorcycle, and this is the part that's removed, and you can see the ring. So I've printed one out, and this is the 3D print, and you can see here one side is a little thicker than the other, so I've added a couple millimeters here, and so we will cast this with the thicker side up, and this will allow some extra material. So in case it's not cast right or needs a little bit adjustment, there's some extra material that always can be removed, sanded, machined, whatever. So I'm going to use a mold box, an existing mold box, and I need to cut out like a dam because the mold box is rectangular and the object we are molding is circular, or essentially will fit in a square. And it doesn't need to be rectangular. So I laser cut this piece and we'll place it inside there. We'll put a little shellac on the cardboard just to seal the cardboard to prevent any of the silicone from seeping into the cardboard. It's not absolutely necessary, but I like to do it just to sort of seal things up so don't have any issues. Do it on both sides since I already have shellac on my brush already. Let that dry, and then we'll use a little bit of PVA or white glue to glue in this dam that goes across the box to make it squarish. I put a little bit of extra white glue, like a little fillet on both sides. This just holds it in because the mold box is waxed, of course, because we don't want anything to stick to it. And so I just put a little extra glue on there just to be safe. Now, again, we're going to use white glue on the 3D printed part, and the white glue works great. It's water-based and it just dries. It's easy to peel off the part later. It doesn't really adhere to anything, but certainly glues the piece down so that we can make the silicone mold. I'm using Silicone Inks GI 1040. And yeah, I'm mixing up kind of a big bucket. I'm mixing up extra for another project at the same time. But mix up the silicone really, really well. Scrape the sides. Get it all mixed up really good. And then we place it into the vacuum tank. And we're going to degas the silicone so we can get all the air out of the silicone. It's going to take roughly 20-ish minutes to degas and take all the air bubbles out of the silicone so that we can pour it into the mold box and make our mold for this magnetic coil ring retainer. We're going to pour in one place and you want to let the silicone flow out and flow over everything. Silicone is cured. Probably about 12 hours later, it's the next day, I remove the screws out of the mold box and we can remove the silicone and the mold from its tomb. All right, let's pry off the sides. And now the separator, the dam part, and we can remove the 3D printed part from the mold itself. Work it out nice and gentle. It does have an undercut, so be careful. I don't want to tear the silicone. I cut the edges of the silicone because this side is going to be facing down and we want it to be flat on the table when we cast apart. I need to do a test cast of the mold just to make sure that there's no bubbles or anything that got trapped in the part during the casting process. I'm going to mix up a little bit of Rompf 3070 standard urethane, and I'm going to inject it in the groove with a syringe. And there's the part. I just let it cure, and we'll put it into the pressure tank to cure for a few hours with a little bit of heat on it. We'll remove the part from the pressure tank. The part was cured at 60 PSI, by the way. Now you see all this extra flash that's on the top that I'm sort of breaking off. This is just a test part. So normally you don't want to do this in production if you're making 10 of these or 100 or 50 or whatever. You would set a piece of flat material that had release agent on it. Let's say like a piece of glass with some wax on the top of the silicone. So that would squeeze out the extra resin and you would have a nice flat surface that was flush with the top of the silicone and you would get a nice part. Again, this was just a test piece just to make sure that the thing came out nice and to make sure that the part was going to be good. I'm not making any of these parts. I'm taking this mold and then shipping it back to my customer so that they can cast these parts in whatever suitable resin that they deem appropriate for this application. And they could use anything that they wanted that was going to work, withstand the heat or the electromagnetic interference or whatever. If your company is looking to do a small production run of cast resin parts, I'll be happy to take a look at your project and give you a quote for making a silicone mold and or casting additional resin parts. Feel free to reach out. You can go to the About section in the channel page or to the Botson website. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Make sure to hit the bell so you get notifications every time I have a new video. Also, don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Links in the description below and on the channel page. Rock on. Don't forget to check out the t-shirts and hoodies in the merch shelf below. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.